Hi guys, tabletnews.com, and I'm here with the Nokia Lumia 1520. This is a phablet that was launched in November 2013. It's a 6-inch device, and we're reviewing right here at tabletnews.com. This is too big for a regular user, so if you want to buy a phablet, this is it. If you want a mirror, Windows Phone handset, you should probably stick to something smaller. We got no stylus here, in spite of this being a phablet. And the price tag, well, this one goes for $629 on Amazon in USA. Now let's discuss the design a little bit. As you can see from the front, we got a classic Fabula design from Nokia. This device measures 8.7 millimeters in thickness, so it's not very bulky and not very thin. It also weighs 209 grams, which is pretty light for such a big 6-inch device. It has a unibody design, and it's basically a Nokia Lumia 1020 without the camera hump at the back. As you can see, the camera is more discreet this time. The design at the back is very similar to the Lumia 925, and we're dealing here with a polycarbonate case. The top and bottom edges are rounded, as you can see if you look closer. And I have to say, this is unlike the Lumia 1020 that had the top and bottom edges straight. All the buttons, the physical ones, are on this side here, camera on, off, and volume. This is a huge device, as you can see, compared to my hand. It's truly huge and it's very hard to reach a certain area of the screen with a single finger. At the top we got the audio jack, right here. And at the bottom we got the micro USB port. At the back we find dual LED flash and the camera sensor right here. We also have four microphones here at the top that you can notice immediately. At the front we got the front camera, we got the display, obviously the earpiece, and these three capacitive buttons between the screen and the lower bezel. Now here on the left side we got the nano SIM card slot and micro SD card slot. Both are removed with the aid of a special metal key that you push in these holes to put out the trays. This case is matte, as you can see it's not glossy, and it's slightly slippery. So if you hold the device in your hand, you must be careful with it, especially because its edges are rounded and the matte case tends to slip. There are four microphones on this device. There are two at the front, two at the back. This is a nice design, but it's maybe a little too big for the average user. Now, if you want to talk specifications, this is a 6-inch screen. This one here, we're dealing with a clear black IPS LCD with a resolution that's Full HD, and we got Gorilla Glass 2 protection, not Gorilla Glass 3. In case you wanted the latest generation, well, that's a bummer for you. The CPU here is a Snapdragon 800 quad-core 2.2 GHz processor with Cryte 400 cores. And we got the Adreno 330 GPU. On the memory side, we got 2 GB of RAM and 32 GB of storage, complemented by the micro SD card slot with support for up to 64 GB of extra space. Other specs here include a 20-megapixel PureView camera at the back with LED flash, dual LED flash, and at the front we got a 1.3-megapixel camera right here. On the connectivity side, we have quad-band GSM GPRS Edge HSDPA with a download speed of 42 mega per second. We got LTE, Wi-Fi dual band, GPS, GLONASS, Bluetooth 4.0, micro USB 2.0, and NFC. Other specs here include active noise cancelling, wireless charging with special accessories, accelerometer, gyroscope, proximity sensor, and a digital compass. We also got a battery here available, obviously. It's a lithium ion 3400 mAh. Our unit. On paper, this battery should provide 760 hours of standby or 27 hours of talk time. We got a bunch of screenshots here to show you how the battery behave in our tests. Okay, so I have to say that on paper this device should provide about 124 hours of music, and in my test that involved keeping the Wi-Fi on and turning the brightness to medium with auto enabled and playing back a Full HD video, well, we have achieved a stunning 17 hours of continuous video playback. That's even better than the iPad mini and even better than any other phone or tablet on the market, any mainstream model. This device charges in 2.5 hours, and we also get a special power saving mode. Remember that with the brightness set to medium, let me show you, So this is medium and I also enable automatic. Then I watched the Full HD video for 17 hours straight. So this is a very good battery. Okay, so let's find that battery saving option I was talking about. Here we go. Battery saver, you can turn it on. Some advanced settings here. And when the battery saver is on, you'll see a little heart symbol next to your battery. So overall, the battery is very impressive. One of the most impressive batteries on any phablet phone or tablet I've tested so far. Now let's address the music aspect. And to address the music, I'm going to enter music plus videos. The speaker is placed right here at the bottom of the device. And we got some music available here. Let's see what we're going to listen to. Let's check out this one. Turn up the volume. Okay, now some conclusions, and while I prepare the conclusions, I'm going to show you the headphones bundled with the device. This is the pair of headphones that is bundled with the handset. As you can see, the headphones are slightly bent over to one side to better fit in the user's ear. They're slightly crooked in a good way, I mean. They're easy to slide in the ear, they're very comfy and very, very loud. Now, as far as the speaker goes, you heard it earlier, and I have to say I'm a bit underwhelmed by this speaker. I was expecting maybe a louder volume. Keep that in mind, it's still loud, but I was expecting just a bit louder and maybe a stronger bass. While the headphones are comfy, are very loud, they have excellent voice and bass. And now going to the settings, let's connect those headphones from earlier that you can also use to receive radio. Okay, so settings, you got audio settings here that you can tweak. We got an equalizer with some presets, a lot of them actually. Of course, you can go with your own custom preset. You tweak the frequencies however you like. We got a special Dolby enhancement, audio leveling for a more consistent playback volume for music and video, and flip to silence. So these are the music enhancements on the device. And if you enter the app from earlier, Music Plus Videos, you'll see that we also have a radio option. Okay, and once again, as usual for Windows Phone devices, there is not a decent fast forward or rewind option. You have to keep the button pressed. You cannot skip ahead to the exact second of the song you want, which I find to be a bummer. So overall, I expected this to be a bit louder, but the headphones are superb, perfect, and however you want to call them. Now, as far as the screen is concerned, this is a 6-inch clear black screen, and I have to say this is an IPS LCD with a Full HD resolution and 368 ppi resolution density. Okay, now let's check out some videos on this beautiful screen. 6-inch IPS LCD, so this means viewing angles should be great. Okay, let's check out this one. This is a test video. 368 ppi density, wide viewing angles. And let's also check out this clip, also test video. Let's turn down the volume. The colors are vivid, the brightness is good, the contrast is pretty nice. And as far as the brightness is concerned, I have something to show you. We use the microscope and some other test devices for this screen, and we achieve some interesting results that we should find here. This is what the screen looks like under a microscope and checking out its pixels. Those are RGB stripe pixels, and we achieve 315 lux units in the center of the screen and 300 lux units on the edges. This is the screen on black. As I said, a pretty bright screen. However, we know it could be brighter since the HTC One, for example, achieves 500 lux units and the Nexus 7 2013 also 500 units. You can use this screen with gloves on your hands. You probably know that. And we got Gorilla Glass 2 protection here, not Gorilla Glass 3. In the settings area, if you want to tweak your viewing experience, you can go to the display and tweak sunlight readability, increase it, or simply adjust the color profile. You can change the color temperature to more neutral, warm, or cool. You can also change the color saturation if you find the screen oversaturated or undersaturated and solve all your problems. This is still a good screen with a pretty good brightness, so no objections here. And now to keep talking about the screen, the sunlight readability is good, the screen is very good, and if you're going to use it in full sunlight, there won't be any problem with reflection. There's also that special glance feature. This is it, glance with special selections that include peak, interval, or always on. And the idea of glance is this: you set the device on standby and you can see various information by waving your hand over the screen. You can see the time, and you can also see other notifications and stuff like that. There's also special settings for touch, so the screen has really been developed here with a bunch of settings and options. So you can tweak your sensitivity, double tap to wake up phone, and that's all the features you're going to get for this screen. You can also tweak the screen rotation. You can lock the screen rotation in certain apps, which is a feature that came with Windows Phone 8 GDR3. This is the screen rotation, auto rotate, turned on or off. The blacks on this screen are not very deep, but overall it's an excellent display. And now we move further to the interesting aspect of the camera. This is a 20 megapixel pure view camera. The sensor size is 1/2.5 inches. This is a Zeiss lens with f2.4 aperture and dual LED flash. We got optical image stabilization, and once you press the camera button on the device that's located right here, let's see what happens. You're going to trigger the Nokia Pro camera application that has become Nokia Camera in the meantime, and it has been seriously updated. Okay, so now we're in the interface. As you can see, we've got a bunch of options here. You probably know this interface from other devices. The interface is pretty simple. You can pull this shutter to trigger all the main options available here. There are 6 camera settings that you see right now. We got flash, white balance, focus, ISO, shutter speed, and exposure. Now I'm playing with the white balance. It's changing in real time. We're playing with the focus. And you can also tweak the ISO going up to 4000, pretty impressive for a camera phone. Then we're playing with the shutter. And finally with the exposure. This one is very cool to play with at night. You can generate nice pictures during the night time. I have to say that one thing is for sure, the camera is faster than the laggy cam we had on the Lumia 1020. And this is a shot I've just taken. Impressive level of detail. Not so much noise, even when you zoom in, so there aren't problems here. Let's see the side options. So we got lenses, front-facing camera, timer available here. This is the timer. And you can also do bracketing. Bracketing basically is the replacement for HDR. This camera does not have HDR, so it takes multiple shots in a certain range of exposure and you choose the one you like the best. Also got your settings here. Focus assist light, framing grids, and capture modes. As you can see, this camera can take 2 pictures at the same time. You take a 16 megapixel picture and a 5 megapixel picture. That one is meant for sharing on social networks, and it's meant for oversampling. Of course, you can also take 90 megapixel shots if you select the 4:3 aspect ratio. And there is a more interesting aspect here that I must mention. You probably noticed an interesting format here. It's called DNG. And I should also mention that there is a lossless zoom of 2x on 5 megapixel shots. So, the shots in 16 megapixels can be raw, If you select this option, DNG, you'll be shooting RAW files, that is DNG digital negative from Adobe. This one is good for editing software. If you're into stuff like that and you want to edit your pictures, you shoot the image in DNG, you use the Adobe technology and you're all set. Keep in mind that a DNG file has 20 megabytes, so you'll be wasting a lot of space to store it. Then you can return to normal mode or simply shoot a 5 megapixel picture and share it on the web. You probably knew that before this device came, Nokia bundled a bunch of applications. They bundled ProCam, SmartCam. Well, SmartCam has become a feature of this application. What SmartCam does is, you'll see right now, it takes a sequence of pictures. Basically, it's a burst shot option. It takes 10 pictures at 5 megapixels and then it offers you a variety of editing modes. There's best shot, so you can choose the best picture. Then there's the option to choose the best face if you have a group of friends. There is also the option for an action shot or motion focus. You can also remove objects that move. An action shot will overlap moving objects. For example, if you have a cat that's jumping, you'll see more versions of the cat put on the screen at the same time. And motion focus adds a motion blur on your device. Of course, if for some reason you don't like this Nokia Pro camera application, you can also go with the standard camera application, the one that you knew from before, from all the other Windows Phone models. This is the standard camera app. These are the standard options here. There is no more cool stuff to add, no more cool options. You cannot pull the shutter anymore. However, you can access the lenses easier. You can see we got Bing Vision, Cinemagraph, Panorama, Nokia Camera, GlamMe, and Refocus. These are the lenses, which are basically apps and features you can add to the camera. With Cinemagraph, you create GIFs. With Panorama, you obviously take panoramas. With GlamMe, you use the front camera and smooth your face straight. And with Refocus, well, that's an entirely different story. So let's see what Refocus does. The idea is to take a photo and then focus. So let's say I take this photo right here and I have a subject in the background, one in the foreground, and I can choose which one to focus on. This is not the case, so let's try an interesting thing here. I'm going to place the castle here and my hand here closer to the camera and see what the foreground and background is. It takes a bunch of photos and then you choose the focus. I can focus on the castle or I can focus on the hand. And I can switch focus to whatever area of the picture I want. If I focus on the background, the foreground becomes blurry. Focus on the foreground, the background becomes blurry. I can also select these options like everything focused or color pop. I can only keep certain colorful areas available here. And then I can also share the pictures via social networking. So this is what Nokia Refocus is all about. Keep in mind that this camera has an ISO level of maximum 4000 and a focal length of 26 millimeters. Now enough with this castle, let's access the gallery and show you some of the shots I have taken in daylight with this camera. I have quite a lot of them, so let's check them out. Some trees in December, we've got excellent colors, excellent brightness, a lot of detail. Got a pretty big gallery here, and keep in mind, as I said, in December, they're taken in December, the sun was setting, so these are pretty good shots for a December gallery. Let's zoom in and see what we're dealing with. Impressive level of detail as usual for Nokia. The contrast is great. There's almost no noise even in the pictures taken in lower light conditions. We even have the cinemagraph used. Take an interesting GIF. Huge gallery. And this is the GIF. Let's open in Cinemagraph and see what it actually does. I selected a single area of the picture to have it moving. I could have selected this area or another one, but this is what Cinemagraph does. some other pictures. This one is more colorful. This is at the sunset and still it's pretty well lit. And we also got a bunch of close-ups to see how the camera handles close-up situations. This is one of the better close-ups, as you can see. Nokia does not have a problem with that. Good close-ups, good panoramas, and good wide shots, so there's no issue here. We even tested the camera during nighttime. These are the night shots. As you can see, there is not a lot of noise, so that's pretty impressive. These are indoor shots and yet again impressive, so this is a pretty good camera. It's close to the Lumia 1020 at night, if you ask me. So not much difference between the two, even though one is a 41 megapixel camera and the other one has a 20 megapixel camera. The video offers optical image stabilization and it offers 3x zoom when shooting 1080p. The default video capture is full HD with 30 frames per second. We got 4 microphones here, so rich recording is available. And the audio capture, when doing video capture, has a bitrate of 256 kilobytes per second and 48 kHz sampling rate. We also have an audio bass filter that filters low frequency noise. One of the bad things about this camera and its many microphones is that they're too easy to hit by mistake. So sometimes you'll hear a deafening sound, which is the sound of you hitting the microphones, someone coughing or the wind. So they're exaggeratedly sensitive. The optical image stabilization is good. We got 3x lossless zoom and the videos are taken with a 19 mega per second bitrate. What was underwhelming here was the night capture. So this is the video shot at night. After seeing those very good night pictures, I was expecting the night video to be just a little bit better. Overall, this camera is perfect for holidays and concerts, and once again, it's not very low compared to the Nokia Lumia 1020. You're not missing much if you bought this one instead of that model. In conclusion, this is an excellent camera that can be easily compared to the one of the Nokia Lumia 1020, and maybe the lack of xenon flash can be considered one of its flaws. You can even start to do some photo editing with Nokia Creative Studio. It's basically a collection of filters that you can add. You can see the filters here. And once you select your ideal filter, you can move on to other editing like focus object, radial and tilt shift, color pop, collage, adjust color balance, brightness, clarity and vibrance, fix stuff and play with the blur. So, as I said, overall excellent camera, nothing to object about here, and we move further to other performance stats. As far as temperature is concerned, with the thermometer on this device, and after playing Asphalt 8 for 15 minutes, the device got really, really hot. The temperature of 45.7 degrees Celsius, and it's hot and you can actually feel it on the backside, which is a bummer for the average user. Now we continue our analysis with a bunch of benchmarks. So let's see, I decided to compare the Nokia Lumia 1520 with the Nokia Lumia 1020, obviously, although this one clearly wins because it has a superior processor, the Snapdragon 800 famous CPU. We scored in WP Bench a score of 441 points, while the Lumia 1020 scored 223, so we clearly beat it. In AnTuTu, we scored 24,000 points, which is double the score of the Lumia 1020. As far as the browsing is concerned, we scored 1973 points in BrowserMark 2.0, while the Lumia 1020 came close with 1597 points. Finally, SunSpider, the lower the better, an incredible score, 558 points, the lower the better, and the Lumia 1020 scored 900 points, so it's lower in the scale of SunSpider. As far as the web browser is concerned, we got Internet Explorer here, and let's access tabletnews.com. Here we go. It's reasonably fast, this web browser, and the keyboard is shaped up for the 6-inch device, so you have to use it with two hands to actually get the typing done faster. This is not the kind of device where you can use a single hand or a single finger to type everything on the screen. Okay, finally our website loaded. You can see how crisp everything is on this 6-inch screen. Let's pinch to zoom. Very smooth, very nice. And this is the web browsing experience with a little hiccup from our website. Hope it will be faster in the future. Okay, now let's talk software here. We're dealing with Windows Phone 8, GDR3, Lumia Black Edition. And one of the things I discovered that this updated version does is nifty multitasking. So you're no longer forced to simply enter the app and push back to close it. We have an X to close each of the apps, which is something I can say finally. They finally implemented this. And other things we got here, we got screen rotation lock, as you saw earlier. We got the driving mode that activates when you connect to a certain Bluetooth accessory in your car. We got that glance mode with special night option. We got refocus and RAW in the camera area. Those are all upgrades that are brought by Windows Phone 8 GDR3 Lumia Black Edition that actually came to some other Nokia devices this week, offered as an update. We also have Bluetooth 4.0 LE support, and we got a nifty app called Nokia Storyteller. This is Nokia Storyteller. It groups pictures by locations, by date, by event. Those are the places where the pictures were taken. You can see them like this, or like this, or like this. You can select favorites. You can see a certain timeline and see both the place and the month when they were taken. There's a slight tutorial here. As you can see, you can group stuff. You can create stories, which is basically collages of images, much like Samsung is doing with its story album. You can edit your home location, save it, save the places. So yeah, if I want to select these pictures and group them into a story, this is it, a story taken today, the 13th. So that was Storyteller, one of the features that came with the new GDR3 Lumia Black update. As far as the phone calling is concerned, we got a pretty loud earpiece here, and also we got good signal, so there won't be any problems with that. We, as usual, have the people area available here with a list of contacts, a list of what's happening now on Facebook and Twitter. Some new leaks of other Nokia handsets. We got a family room and groups, and that's pretty much it when it comes to phone calling. Now we're in that section of the review called apps, where we analyze all the pre-installed apps on the device. We got App Social, which is basically a highlights app showing you recommended applications that you should download on your freshly bought device. Got a bunch of apps and games here in the spotlight. We got an apps feed. Can sign in, we got a leaderboard. These are the most listed apps, those are the most followed people, most loved lists. So basically, sort of a social networking twist given to the best of apps selection. Then comes the Bing Suite with Bing Finance. Of course, most of you will not even use this. Some of you get your news straight from Yahoo or Google or who knows what other source. We got Bing Sport. I've seen these apps before on Windows 8 and Windows RT tablets, and now they're pre-installed here. I wonder if they'll be pre-installed on other Windows Phone devices as well. Okay, then comes the usual suite of calculator, calendar, camera, DataSense. You can actually set a limit for your usage of mobile data. As you can see, we downloaded 1.79 gigabytes. Then comes Xbox Games. This is where we store our games, sign in with our profile, and all that. And then comes the driving suite, so to call it. We got here Drive Plus. You can select a destination, and the usual Nokia driving experience is here. Set the destination, set your favorites, set your location, find your car. Nice feature, this one. It's in beta mode. These are the settings. You can find your navigation voice and download a new one. Select the units, select the route settings, ferries, speed alerts, battery saving, navigation license, speed limit warning, basically everything you need to have on a lifetime driving application, 3D graphics included, zoom in and zoom out available, and as I said, this Final Cut feature, I guess it wasn't here before because it's in beta and it's brand new. If you don't want to navigate around, you can simply check out for cool restaurants and places to shop with Nokia Here Maps. You can localize yourself by pressing this button. You can select the layers you want to show, including one that's augmented reality based. And you can also get traffic information around your area. And obviously you can find places like areas to shop, restaurants, malls, or gas stations, or places like that. And finally, the third of the suite is here, transit. Select the place you want to go to and you'll see what vehicles you need to use, what subway stations. You need to take the bus, you need to take the tram, or you need to take the subway and you should be there. Those are the minutes. You can also get alternatives, so you can switch your route if you want to go to work to a more efficient way. Okay, now we also got a new app. It's called Nokia Beamer. And if I want to use Nokia Beamer, I'm going to use a second device to test it. Okay, so we got this handset right here. And welcome to Nokia Beamer. Share nearby. I have to go to beam.nokia.com. This is the iPhone 5, by the way. And once I'm here, I can scan this barcode using the Nokia Lumia handset. And I will be able to see on the screen whatever I see here. So if I shake it once, I'm going to see the exact same image. I'm going to shake it now and the image got transported there. And I can even do this while I'm in the camera. Let's go back to the app and select show what you see. So for example, I'm seeing this phone, and if I shake it, my phone sees itself to the camera, which is pretty cool. Okay, enough with this cool feature. Remember its name. It's called Nokia Beamer, and it's actually inspired by the Photo Beamer app. It's kind of redundant to have both of them, but that's it. Of course, we got Office available here, with the usual sample documents, spreadsheets, stuff to edit. You can also play with PowerPoint and stuff like that. Nothing has changed from the experience you know. We got SkyDrive integration, and bundled we got the Xenio app. It's your one stop for digital magazines. You got your reading list here. You can also shop for magazines. There is a more section. Apparently dolphins aren't smiling. Change the font size. So basically it's sort of a relative of Flipboard if you want a comparison. And those are some of the apps that you need to look into. The other ones are pretty basic. You got your wallet right here that you already know, Nokia Panorama, GlamMe, and the other ones that you already know. And that's the full suite that we're going to use, plus obviously the store where you can find Nokia collection and download all the apps you need, want, or desire. It's time for the conclusion. This is the Nokia Lumia 1520, and it's time for a verdict related to this device. So we got the pros and cons. On the pro side, we got an excellent battery with 17 hours of continuous video HD playback. We got perfect headphones. We got the inclusion of a micro SD card slot. We got lots of cool apps to play with. You saw those earlier. We got a very good display that's both crisp, bright, and we also got good viewing angles, colors that pop. We have a very good back camera that doesn't feel lower than the 41 megapixel one from the Nokia Lumia 1020. There is no lag whatsoever in the interface and in the games, so we're getting a very good experience out of it. Benchmarks are also good, excellent performance, and I like very much the new features that have been added with the latest Windows Phone 8. That we got refocus, we got RAW for the camera, new glance features, and other stuff like that. Now on the cons side, I was maybe expecting the speaker to be just a bit louder, and this phone, this 6-inch phone, may be too big for most of the people. Also, it's kind of slippery, as I said earlier. These many microphones here will make the camera capture the audio capture too sensitive, and you may hear loud sounds when filming. You may hit the microphones by mistake. Some of the apps are redundant. For example, we got Nokia Beamer and we got Photo Beamer. One of them becomes redundant. And also the handset gets kind of hot, 45 degrees Celsius when playing Asphalt 8. Those are the cons. And finally, this model could have maybe used a stylus since its screen is so big. And by the way, speaking of stylus, its price tag is bigger than the one of the Galaxy Note 3, yet another bummer. Okay, so we give this device a 9 out of 10 for design, 9.2 out of 10 for the hardware, and finally a 9 out of 10 for operating system and user interface, because we really like the nice apps that are bundled with it. The final grade is 9.06 out of 10, and this is a very good phablet, one of the best we've tested, and certainly the best phablet with Windows Phone 8 right now. This is tabletnews.com, and the Nokia Lumia 1520 gets a 9.06 out of 10 from us. Bye bye.